I get a flesh machine. Iggy Pop should have put out his own line of flesh machines. Hey, Drunk Sue.
Hey, baby.
Speaking of hypnotizing chickens, what's going on out there?
No, I just want to let you know that I'm resting up.
I was going to say, I got a message from Drunk Sue on the After Hours line, I think over the weekend, and you sounded downright somber.
Well, because I was mad because I want watermelon with seeds in it. It tastes a lot better.
I really should have listened to that whole message. You wanted
watermelon. Don't you think that watermelon with seeds in it tastes a lot better? It's a lot sweeter.
I'm pretty new to the watermelon game. I never liked it growing up. It seemed like a lot of work for very little payoff. I enjoy it as an adult, but I don't care if there are seeds or not. I would.
If you take a watermelon with seeds and a watermelon without, and you just taste the flesh, okay? There's going to be a lot more flavor in the watermelon with seeds in it.
With seeds. But are you saying that you're having a hard time finding it with seeds?
Yeah, I can't find any watermelon unless I go down to Green Farms, clean down in West, by God.
Well, I was going to say, there must be farmers markets near you where there's just people selling.
Oh, yeah, there are.
Well, go there.
Yeah, way closer than you.
Well, yeah. What's a problem?
Well, nothing. I just hate that I can't just go to the store and get what I want. I have to go 15 miles.
I see.
Why?
Why can't she find watermelons with seeds?
Why?
I didn't know that we were so overrun with seedless watermelon. You ever see those square watermelons? For a while, they were trying to make them square. So they,
Oh, do you remember this funny story?
This better be funny.
I remember 7 or 8 years ago, China, I think, maybe, they planted a whole bunch of watermelons, but they put a whole bunch of steroids in it, and all of the watermelons exploded.
Yeah, I think that was Japan that did that. I think they were on the forefront of watermelon technology.
Yeah. But anyways, I just want to let you know I'm resting up because, St. Patty's Day. I'm Irish.
Yeah, but Sue, isn't every day, A, it wouldn't matter if you were Irish. B, isn't every day kind of like St. Patrick's Day for you?
Pretty much.
Yeah. So are you saying that you go extra ham on St. Patrick's Day?
She goes corned beef.
No, I got to save myself up so I can really do it on Thursday.
Oh, so you're resting up. I see. You're preparing for a performance. Is there any chance that you'll be coming into the city to join Bill Squire's bar crawl on the morning of St. Patrick's Day? Or are you just going to do it out in the sticks?
I'm going to do it out here in the sticks.
Yeah, okay.
No, you'll be missed.
And my heart will be with him. I'll
Thanks.
Be thinking about him.
As long as I have your heart with me.
There you go. Yeah. Because,
Friday, I got a party on Friday.
Yeah, you got to get down on Friday.
You got to get down on Friday.
Yeah. That's when the weekend begins.
Right. That is when the...
No. What is Friday, Alan?
What is Friday?
It's your birthday?
Really? It's your birthday, is it?
That's right.
Oh. Got to get down on Drunk Sue's birthday Friday. Fun, fun. Will you be getting drunk on Friday? Drunk Sue's birthday's on Friday. What will she be having? What will she be having? Some fun, fun, fun. What?
I love you, Alan.
Okay. Love you too, Drunk Sue. Happy pre-birthday. Boy, she's got a big week. She's got... St. Patrick's Day on Thursday, which again, I'm surprised that she's doing anything different for St. Patrick's Day. I guess there's like a mental thing, right?
Mm-hmm.
People go, "Oh, it's St. Patrick's Day. I've got a party." And they go, "Well, don't you party every day?" "Yes, but today's a day where I can get other people to do it. It's a weekday where I can get other people to do it with me." See, I think that come Thursday, Drunk Sue is at some point during the course of her day, no matter what she's doing. And whatever she's doing, you best believe she's going to go hard. But at some point, it's going to occur to her that her experience is subpar because it will not be powered by Bud Light. And listen, when it comes to...
Powered by Four Locos.
Huh?
So hers is powered by Four Locos.
I don't know if powered's the right word.
Right. Yeah, right. By 16 Locos. But she'll be... Alan Drunk Sue does know that watermelons with seeds aren't in season in March, correct?
Yeah, well...
Yeah, but neither are strawberries, and those are around. I mean, you can get a watermelon at the store, probably with seeds.
Probably why it's so...
Tell you what, I got seeds. Go buy a watermelon. I'll put some seeds in it for you.
Mm-hmm.
Make it work. I bet it tastes great, isn't it?
Alan, I agree with Sue. It's the it's like when you breed the seeds out, and you breed out the sweetness. Yeah, but there's no... And you might be right. I'm just saying that there's no flavor to the seeds.
I can't remember watermelon ever being that good.
Bro, I love watermelon. I was just about to say, I mess up a watermelon. Like, I'll buy a whole watermelon for myself, cut it up, and eat it in like 2 days.
Yeah, we've cut them up and given it, like our daughter loves them and all that. So I've tried to, over the years as a grown-up, I've tried to get more into watermelon. Couldn't care less about it as a kid.
When you buy the perfect watermelon, when it's like equal parts juicy and sweet, and it's that deep red color, but it's not stringy or mealy, oh my God. That is like, I will be cutting it up and eat half of it as I'm cutting it up. I love watermelon.
Well, as I established yesterday on the show, my process for shopping for produce is that I will, to determine if something's ripe or to my liking, I will poke the produce.
Yes. Now, poke a hole in it.
I'll poke a hole in it. Now,
you're a hole poker.
He is.
Yeah.
I have my assumptions.
As it's proven to be a little bit more difficult with watermelon, as you might suspect. I really got to get like a Kill Bill rigid kind of, you know, five-fingered death punch thing going there, and I really have to stiffen up my finger. You know what I'm talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
I got to have stiff little fingers, and then I jam them in there, and then I, you know, will peer inside.
What produce are you talking about here?
All produce. Yes.
We were talking about shopping for produce because I bought eggplant yesterday to make eggplant parmesan, which
and
came out.
And he would jam a thumb in it and be like, this isn't ripe.
Well, no, I said I didn't know how to shop for eggplant. I've never bought it before, so I didn't really know what it was supposed to feel like.
Those emojis and no idea how to shop for it.
And Alan then shared the way that he shops for all produce, regardless.
Well, and I'll tell you what, the places that I frequent, they kind of give me a wide berth because they see me coming. They know what I do. They kind of try to run interference for me because not only am I poking, that's only step one. I also have gear. So step two is I usually have a laparoscope with me or a speculum, and I like to jam those in there so I can really get a good look.
Are you touching the sides of the peach? Just a little pressure as you insert the speculum?
Mary, now you're being silly. As I, a peach is so small, I can do it with my finger. I'm talking about the larger pieces of produce, right? Your watermelons, your rutabagas, your cantaloupes, right? You need a laparoscope for those. And so anyway, short story long, if you ever come upon a piece of produce,
I would just
it's got a hole poked in it, just because it wasn't good enough for me doesn't mean that it's not good enough for you. Don't pass that up.
I made a very good pep smear joke and you guys didn't think it was funny because you've never had one.
I knew what it was.
Are you implying that I didn't understand the joke?
I hope.
I have dated and been married to women my entire life.
Have you been dated to a pep smear?
I have been invited to a number of pap smears. I've actually unofficially given a number of them.
Ew.
Well, I did tell you I own a speculum. Yes. So I, it's not that I didn't understand what a pap smear
was.
Just
say that.
It's that it wasn't funny.
I am a professional comedian.
Nevertheless, she is a professional comedian. That's right.
What was that funny thing that you were saying today, Alan, about, some sort of miscarriage of something?
Miscarriage of justistus is... The hashtag that, boy, I certainly hope would take off in the wake of Jussie Smollett.
I don't think it will.
Nor do I. It still doesn't dampen my love for that particular hashtag. Mary just said, bro, I will mess up a watermelon.
I will, man. I love
it. I do like the image of you because, you know, cutting it into, you know, kids will put it in front of their face because it looks like a smile, the whole bit, you know.
Uh-huh.
You just tear an ass through a watermelon.
Oh, yeah, because I cut it into triangles, so it's easier to eat. So it goes in halves and then quarters.
Oh, you don't just slice it. You don't just do like a semicircle slice and go to town on that. You're like pie shaping it.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
And then I'll eat a half a watermelon in a sitting. No problem.
Watermelon seeds are very healthy. Don't spit out your seeds. I'm not a seed spitter. I will eat the seeds. I eat the stones out of cherries. Like, I don't. I pop them in and eat them. I don't spit.
Aren't you an apple core guy, too?
Yeah, I'll eat the whole apple. It's where the vitamins are in the seeds.
What do you love
vitamins. It's true. What do you think makes them grow? Yeah,
don't you take daily vitamins?
Huh?
You take daily vitamins, right?
It's never enough.
It's well, but you're getting your nutrients from food is obviously the optimum way to do it. Yeah. That's how I grew up. Don't waste the apple. Why throwing away the core? It's a good part. It doesn't taste bad. A little bitter. But that's not the end of the world, right? Mm-hmm. Cherries. What about? I'll be sitting there spitting into a bowl the whole time?
Yes.
No. I'd rather go to the bathroom and hear pating, 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 pating. That's more fun.
Do you pooping eat the, like a deer.
Right, yeah.
Yeah.
Rabbit
that's,
poops.
That's more fun.
Do you eat the pit of avocado, too?
I don't eat avocado.
Oh, yeah. Nature's butter. This guy.
I obviously won't eat the stone in a peach. That's too big. But a little pit in a cherry, I'll swallow it.
Okay,
just fine.
But you bite
watermelon
into it
seeds,
and then you just swallow it.
What's
the
that?
Pit of a cherry is not chewy.
No, but you can kind of eat around it with the meat of the cherry, and then I swallow the whole thing. To me,
never
it's
even occurred to me to do that.
No, never, not once.
And understood. I get that that's not like, you know, I just don't want to be sitting there.
The apple thing, I've no problem with that. I don't care about that. But
I don't want to be sitting there with a bowl just because I'm having some cherries and spitting into them and then you got to dump them.
That's why you do it like me.
Because you're just holding cherries in each hand. Right. No bowls for me. Can't get a bowl. I just got all these.
No, I hold out my shirt and make a little scoop out of it. No, but two bowls. I've got a bowl of cherries. I don't need another one for the pits.
You can
I'll eat the whole thing.
Spit the pits back into the bowl.
Oh,
with the
God.
Other cherries.
And then you're trying to separate chewed up.
I just eat them over the trash can like an adult. Leave the lid open, spit, eat, spit.
Mm-hmm.
Duh.
Listen, everybody can do whatever they want to do. No judgment. That's just me.
No, there's a judgment.
There's a lot of judgment.
No, no judgment on my part.
Oh, yeah.
For people not taking the easy way out and swallowing those cherry pits.
I feel like you're still judgy.
And you're not, it's not like it's the easy way out. It's not like it takes an hour to get a pit out of a cherry.
It's an extra unnecessary step.
Do you have a shortage of bowls in your house?
God, we have too many bowls.
Then you should use more of them.
Too many
Hopefully
bowls.
Hopefully one will break, and then there you go. Problem solved.
No. Too many bowls. Alan, when was the last time you bought a rutabaga? You son of a bitch, I bought one a couple of days ago. Thank you very much. Yes, I did. I like turnips. I like rutabagas.
I forgot to give...
You got
to
get your goddamn root vegetables.
Yeah.
Are you animals walking around not eating root vegetables?
I eat whatever I want.
My boyfriend wants me to gain 200 pounds, all right? I'm not going to do that by eating rutabagas.
Air fryer eggplant parm was pretty bad.
Oh, yeah, you made that.
It was good.
Did it turn out all right?
Yeah, it was
How
really
do you
good.
Air fry an eggplant parmesan?
You cut them into circles. Cut them into little circles.
But isn't... I thought eggplant parmesan was like a thing you put in a casserole dish.
You can. So I cut the eggplant into circles and then flour, eggs.
Oh, you individually did them as like a...
Yeah, like
I
almost
see.
Like little steaks. And then so I breaded each little circle.
That's not normally how it's done, right?
No.
You did that because you were going to air fry them.
Right.
Gotcha.
Well, because I wanted to save on like the oil and all that kind of stuff. So then you like fried them, flipped them over, and then put sauce and cheese on it and put it back in. So it like, it oh, gave the cheese like a
crust,
nice little brown, yeah, browning on there. It was really good.
The browning.
The browning.
Is what we like to call that.
Oh, I like my cheese when it's got a little brown on it.
There
you know?
You go. The
What's
browning.
What I want? It's, well, yeah, you want to get a little brown.
I understand.
I know, but
yeah.
It's just still.
It's a great band called The Browning.
The spaghetti was spaghetti, but it was pretty good eggplant brown.
Apple seeds contain arsenic. Peach pits have cyanide. Yeah, but again, if people were like, arsenic, you would need to eat a giant barrel of apple seeds. For it to even begin to
then
make you feel
it.
A little bit queasy. I
but
will, thanks very
it.
Much.
Prove the point.
Alan peels his whole banana, but eats cherry pits and apple cores. Who taught you to eat fruit?
Yeah, seriously.
I'll tell you who taught me to eat fruit.
Mother.
Dr. Elgin Glimrimple taught me how to eat fruit.
Mother,
as a young man.
With
mother.
Her beautiful voice, and that's why nobody else can sing, because only mother may sing, and I will eat fruit the way mother says.
Darling, why don't you peel the banana before you eat it?
Yes, mother.
Why are you spitting out your cherry pits?
I don't know.
Molasses.
Listen, I didn't get to pick. I was under their roof.
But you can pick now. You are an adult man who can choose to eat food normally, and you do not.
What do you mean normally?
Not eating
spit
the
your pits.
Yes, there's nothing.
Okay, fine, but I don't see that as abnormal. I see it as unusual. That doesn't mean abnormal.
So annoying sometimes.
Why?
Semantic
I'm
arguments.
I'm not hurting anybody.
You're
it's
not.
True.
You're not.
And unnatural
you know
does not mean abnormal.
I am
you're,
hurt.
Bill's hurt.
You hurt me.
Look at him. He had to take off yesterday when he heard about your cherry pits.
Yeah, that's right.
I was on my way in.
Then
I heard
you
about
turned
you
around.
Swallowing cherry pits, and I was like,
you know what?
Oh, he's fingering produce.
Today's going to be a great day, then he'd see you're hurting. I got to get the hell out of here.
Like me at a gazebo when he's buying produce.
But it tastes
that's right.
Not a light touch.
Yeah.
He has a whole poker.
Vegetables are my gazebo. What do you want from me? The way Bill is in a public park, that's how I am in a produce section. Tell Mary to slow cook next time. That's the point of an air fryer. You don't want to slow cook.
It took like
I got to set it and forget it for 6 minutes. Hours. Well, there you go.
You leave it on one side for 8 minutes,
yeah,
flip
you want
it over.
It crispy.
Yeah, it was 8 minutes on one side, flip it over for 4, and then after 4 you add the sauce and the cheese and leave it on for another 8, so 16 whatever how many minutes that is enough minutes.
that's enough minutes. How many minutes do I put this in? Enough minutes.
Enough minutes to have
it. And then it's done.
Look at the minutes and that's enough.
Mm-hmm.
My boyfriend's super OCD, and so he doesn't cook a lot, and because of the mess it makes. So when
Orange County Democrat.
Yes.
Yeah.
He's from California.
Yep.
Have I not mentioned that?
No, you have.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah.
But the process of breading anything is a messy process. Flour, egg, breadcrumbs,
panko,
gotta lay it
the whole bit.
All that
yep.
stuff. And so he's standing in the kitchen just kind of watching. I was like, go sit down somewhere. Like, if you're not.
Because it's so messy?
Yeah, and I've got like sauce going in one pan and mushrooms in another, and then the spaghetti's boiling and it's hot, and there's a lot going on in the kitchen. And he's just like standing there, like, gonna start cleaning up. I was like, you need to go watch a murder documentary and get out of this kitchen. Like,
don't watch me do this.
Right.
I'm doing this for you. Don't look over my shoulder. Yeah, I get out of the kitchen if Gwen's cooking, because she'll go, leave it.
Stop touching things.
Just leave it.
Yes.
Just, I still need that.
Yeah. Right.
Where's that spoon?
Yes.
I put it in the dishwasher. I need that spoon. Go
yes,
away.
Yes, he's like
just
cleaning as I'm trying to cook. I'm like, stop touching things.
I know, I'm that guy. I'm really annoying. I'm like cleaning up after people when they're doing stuff. My wife said one time, she goes, she said to somebody, maybe Nora, she goes, if your father is around, it means that something is being picked up. And it was the nicest thing anybody had ever said to me before.
Thank you. I
it
do
was
like
so
a tiny
sweet.
House.
It was so sweet. Something is being picked up if Alan is around. Yeah! How do you think Darlene from Ozark killed her husband? Cyanide made from pits. Is that true?
Yeah,
well,
like a
spoiler
whole
alert.
Bunch.
Jeez. I mean, it was season 2. But.
Yeah, I'm sorry. It was a couple seasons ago. Certainly don't want to diminish anyone's enjoyment of that show. Okay, listen, I've...
Wasn't 5 pits, though. I mean,
she also was a drug lord. She probably had some cyanide.
Why not just give him an overdose of heroin, by the way?
I don't think heroin goes in coffee.
Heroin goes in anything, Mary. Anything. It's a complimentary flavor. I got to take a break. If you want to get the last word in, send me a text 35192, and we'll be back. It's the Alan.